guys! Today's video is going to be 5 mistakes guinea pig owners make. Trust the pet shop without doing research first. It's always a good idea to do one's own research and then getting expert help, if needed. But in order to know who really is an expert, it's good to do research first so that you can identify if someone is giving you good or bad advice. Lots of pet shop employees are passionate about their job and pets, but there's always people who just want to sell things or who know a lot about, let's say, dogs, but not a lot about guinea pigs. So it's always important to fact check new information. Separating too early. Guinea pigs don't communicate as humans do, and sometimes their style of communication looks like fighting to us. We tend to feel sorry for them and want to help them, but in a lot of cases, guinea pigs are separated too early before they could solve their issues. Chasing, rumble strutting, loud complaints, and nipping is perfectly normal guinea pig behavior. If guinea pigs are separated during this tense period of time, they cannot solve their issues. Whenever you put them together after separation, they're going to start the same conflict again, which looks very aggressive to us, which makes us want to protect the guinea pig being chased and intervene, which leads to separation, and it's kind of a circle that's very hard to break. Guinea pigs need to be separated if one guinea pig is losing a lot of weight because of the constant stress, or there are bite marks, especially in the back area and around the throat. Chasing, loud noises, scratch marks in the area around their nose and ears can last for days and is perfectly normal and not a reason to separate. And sometimes, if a guinea pig grows older, this type of conflict starts again. Waiting too long before going to the vets. Guinea pigs have mastered the skill of hiding a sickness. That's a great idea for a prey animal in the wild, and not such a great thing if you live in your human's house with access to a vet. Piggies tend to show their illness at a point where it usually has progressed quite a bit, so you'll definitely want to take your guinea pig to the vet as soon as possible. Taming is or can be hard work. Guinea pigs look like super cute stuffed animals. Add to that people telling you that they had really tame guinea pigs growing up or seeing unusually tame guinea pigs online, and you can easily get a false sense of guinea pig taming. Some people get really lucky and adopt guinea pigs that somehow have forgotten that they're prey animals and are very brave and pretty much tame already. That's how you get stories of, "I tamed my guinea pig within a day." Others invest a lot of time and energy in their guinea pigs, and it's only after months or years that you really see a big change. So a common mistake is thinking that guinea pigs will be tame after a week of getting them. Underestimating how much space they really need. And I'm not even talking about cage space, because you probably all know that they need a lot of room to run around, whether they get floor time or not. They need a huge enclosure to run and explore whenever they feel like it, and not whenever you're at home. I'm talking about hay, bedding, additional hidies, or fleece items, or a first aid kit. All of this takes up a lot of space. Veggies will also take up a lot of space in your fridge. Fur and hay will also find its way on your clothes and in every room in your house. So be prepared for guinea pigs to take up a huge amount of space in your house and in your heart and thoughts. These were 5 common mistakes that guinea pig owners make. I definitely made some of these in the past. I hope you enjoyed this video, and see you guys next time!